Welcome back to our second lesson, the wave motion. We had said in lesson one, the wave motion is a type of an oscillatory motion as it repeated regularly in equal periods of time around its rest point. So when we are going to discuss the wave motion, we can simply transfer the transferring of the energy or the role of waves in transferring the energy. As if you throw a stone in the water, like this water, we can see these are concentric circles which propagates in the water surface. The word of propagate means spreads in the water surface, and this will be considered as a wave motion. Also, if you have three or four coins, if you push in the first coin, all the energy of the first coin will be affected to the three last coins, and so the energy will be propagated in the same direction of the force you have done. So our conclusion, the distribution which propagates and transfers through energy, it will be in the same direction of the propagation, and this will be called a wave. And so the concept of the wave motion, it will be the movement which resulted from the vibration of the medium particles at certain moment in a specific direction, and this is called the wave motion. And so the wave motion, it will be defined as the total movement of the particles of the medium in a certain movement or a certain moment in a, with a definite direction. So when we look to this pole, when the pole moves up and down, this total movement of the all particles in this medium, it will be transferred or spread in a definite direction. So the wave, it will be the distribution in the medium which propagates in a different direction and speed, and it transfers the energy in its speed direction, as we said when you throw the stone or pushing the coin. So after this, we are going to ask yourself about what is the definite direction. So if we look to this figure, we see this is the movement of the water. Imagine this is the water molecule during its movement. So this direction of the propagation of the wave, it will be considered as the line of the wave propagation. Again, the direction of the water particles spreads or propagates during its movement, it will be called the line of the wave propagation. It will be defined as it is the direction through which the wave propagates. Now we are going to classify the waves according to the direction or the vibration of the particles and according to the ability to propagate. We have some waves can be propagate or can be transferred the particles and or transfer the energy through the particles, and the other waves cannot transfer the energy. First, let's start by the types of the waves according to the direction or the vibration of the particles. We have a transverse waves and we have longitudinal waves. Let's start by the transverse waves. First, we are going to make an activity by using this UU. We are going to look to the UU would be moves up and down, up and down, up and down. So we are going to discuss that the disturbance of the air molecules or the medium particles will be vibrate perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation. Let's see. Here is the direction as we move from left to right. This is the wave propagation, but the particles moves up and down, up and down, up and down. So the movement to move the particles moves up and down, and the wave propagation, the distribution of the energy from left to right. So this distribution, it will be perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation. So again, the transverse wave, it is the distribution in which the particles of the medium vibrates perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation, as we see in this picture. Second one is what's the mean by the crust. If we look to this transverse wave, when we have the up and down, the maximum point or the highest point where the medium vibrates, it will be called crust. So this point is called crest. It's called what? Crest. What's meant by crest? The highest point of the particles of the medium of the transverse wave. And when the medium continue to be movement down to the lowest point, this is called trough, 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 It is the lowest point of the vortex of the medium of the transverse wave. So the transverse wave consists of crust and trough. The transverse wave, the vibration of the medium vortex will be perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation. Let's continue. The second type is the longitudinal waves. The longitudinal waves, as we look at this point, and we have this movement of the UU, it will be moved left and right, not up and down, such as the transverse wave. When we look to this movement, we have some circles very close to each other and others far away from each other. So we can determine the distribution of the medium particles will be along or in the same direction of the wave propagation. As we look in these waves, the waves moved from left to right, and the same for the direction of the wave propagation. So the difference between the transverse and the longitudinal, the transverse, it will be perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation, while longitudinal in the same or along the direction of the wave propagation. We have an example here for the longitudinal waves, such as the sound waves. As we said before, in the longitudinal waves, we have some circles very close to each other and very far away from each other. When they are very close to each other, this is called compression. Again, compression, compression. Compression, it is the areas at which the particles are too close to each other, where it have the highest density and pressure. Again, have the highest density and pressure. And the areas where the circles or the particles far away from each other, it's called rarefactions. Rarefactions. These rarefactions, it is the areas at which the particles are too far apart from each other, which means it have a lowest density and the pressure. Let's continue. Here we have a comparison between the longitudinal and transverse wave. It's a very important comparison. The point of the comparison first, for motion of the particles. Here, it's perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation. Here, it's the same direction of the wave direction. The nature of the waves, here it consists of crests and troughs. Here, the longitudinal consists of compressions and refractions. Here, the examples for some transverse waves, such as the seawater waves, the light waves, the radio waves, longitudinal waves, such as the sound and spiral coil waves. Let's continue. We have some live applications, such as jacuzzi. Jacuzzi, it's like the panel, but it will be used for treat the sprains and the cramps by using the hot water, and the nervous tension by using the cold water. Now we are going to discuss the second type of the waves, which is the mechanical and electromagnetic. As we said before, it classified according to the ability to propagate the waves. Here we have the mechanical waves. It is the waves which can spread through the medium, such as solids or liquid or gases. But the electromagnetic waves, it doesn't need a medium to propagate through it. It can propagate or can it be spread through medium or the vacuum. Here the mechanical waves, its speed is very low, as it equals 340 meters per second, such as the sound speed. And it consists of transverse and longitudinal waves. While the electromagnetic, it doesn't, as we said before, it doesn't need a medium to propagate through. It can be spread through the vacuum, such as the light which coming from the sun. There is no air particles between the sun and the earth. So the light, it will be considered as electromagnetic transverse wave. Why we call it transverse? Because its direction is going to be perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation. And also we have another example for the radio waves. Let's continue. Here we have the very important give reasons for this point. Sound waves are mechanical longitudinal. Now focus in this question, you need to answer about why it's mechanical and why it's longitudinal. First, why it's a mechanical? Because it's the only spread in the medium as the air. And it will be why it's longitudinal, because it's formed from compressions and refractions. And if you want to answer because its direction is along or in the same direction of the wave propagation, it's very right also. Second question, the light waves are electromagnetic transverse. Why? Because they can spread in both medium and vacuum. And why it's transverse? Because it consists of crust and troughs. Also, if you want to when you want to answer or complete your question, you complete your answer by also its direction, it's in the perpendicular to the direction of the wave propagation, no problem. The last question, the frequency of the vibrating body decreases with the increase in the periodic time. Why? Because we said before, the frequency has a direct or inversely proportional relationship with the periodic time. Here we have some concepts related to the wave motion, as we have the concept related to the oscillatory motion. First, we have the wavelength. What's meant by the wavelength? Here, it will be the distance between two successive crests or two successive troughs, as in the transverse wave. Or it will be calculated by the distance between the centers of two successive compressions or rarefactions. Again, here is the wavelength between two centers of compressions or the two centers of rarefactions, as in the longitudinal wave, while the wavelength will be considered the distance between the two successive crests or two successive troughs. As we look to the symbol of the wavelength, of course it likes the shape of letter H, but it's different as it have a curved slash. Let's continue. The law of the wavelength. How can we calculate the wavelength? In the transverse wave, it will be 2 pi the horizontal distance between the crests or troughs. If we have from the longitudinal waves, it will be 2 pi the distance between the centers of compressions or rarefactions. Or by another rule, the wavelength equal the distance which covered by the waves divided the number of waves. So again, we have 3 rules to calculate the wavelength according to the problem you have. Let's continue. The second concept is the amplitude. The amplitude, it is the maximum displacement which covered by the medium particles away from its rest point, such as the amplitude in the oscillatory motion. The amplitude can be classified here or can be calculated here from the vertical distance between the crests and troughs but divided 2. Let's continue. The wave velocity. How can we calculate the velocity? It is the distance covered by the wave in the 1 second. So the wave velocity will be symbolized by letter V equals distance covered by the wave over time in second. The speed in the sound, as we said in the wood, equal 1850 meters per second. For the water, it will be 1400. For air, 340 meters per second. So the velocity in solids bigger than in liquids, bigger than in gases. Let's continue. The wave frequency. How can we calculate it? It's the number of the waves which will be divided to the time from the source in the 1 second. So, of course, if you get the frequency, it's be easy to get the periodic time, 1 over the frequency. How can we get the law of the wave propagation? The law of the wave propagation would be calculated from the wave velocity equal frequency by the wave length. So now let's test your knowledge for this lesson. The waves are classified according to the ability to propagate in the space according to mechanical and electromagnetic. Number 2, the crest in the, yes, of course, it will be in the transverse waves, which are represented by what in the longitudinal waves? Of course, the crest equals the compressions in the longitudinal waves. 3, radio waves are, yes, very good. It will be mechanical transverse wave, which can propagate in the space by speed of, yes, very good. It will be transferred by 3 by 10 power negative 12. Thank you. Please study this lesson very well and see you in Unit 2. Thank you. Bye-bye.